Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Today we're going to be diving into Hey.com. This is a new email application that is set to release in July 2020 from the folks at Basecamp. We'll be going over all that you need to know, including the pricing, some of the features, and a little bit about their manifesto. So in today's video, let's roll into talking about Hey.com. So as I said, today's video is all about email. It's quite an interesting space at the moment, especially with Superhuman, Newton's return, and we're going to be reviewing a Spike 2.0 this week as well. So it's very interesting how this is turning out. So what I want to start with is what Hey.com is about. So unlike tools like Superhuman and Newton, they're normally clients. This is actually going to be an email service itself, very similar to, say, the likes of Gmail or Outlook. You will get something called an @hey.com address. So it becomes an actual email base itself. Now, on top of this, they'll layer this lovely client, which is available on web, Mac, Linux, Windows, iPhone, iPad, and Android, which is good out of the box. Now, for those who don't know, Basecamp is a fairly old company, 21 years old, and they've been very much the endorsers of remote work. This sort of like people first companies versus, you know, say necessarily aggressive sort of marketing folks. But they've been profitable for 21 years and a fully independent company. So they talk a lot about this sort of email manifesto, this Hey manifesto that essentially changes the way that you think about email. And they've introduced a fair few sort of concepts. They even state in their sort of opening page that email deserves a dust off, a renovation, modernized for the way we email today. And to some extent, I agree with that, because a lot of the way that we sort of communicate today is through sort of synchronous communication, a lot of Slack, a lot of these instant messages. And this application sort of tries to dust off those approaches. Now, let's start with the price. I think it's important to start with the price because it's quite an expensive application, but something that, as a personal email tool, if you're willing to pay, then it's something that I guess sort of prices itself in a similar sort of range as sort of Microsoft 365 per year, sort of range. It is $99 per year for that email. And that works out about $825 a month. Which is reasonable. For example, I pay, I think it's $12 or $15 for missives. So again, a little bit cheaper than some of the tools out there. And if you're looking at, say, Superhuman, again, that's $30 a month, so dramatically cheaper. And if you're looking at, say, Newton, Newton's $49 a year, so maybe double the price of Newton, but again, obviously some of the things there. They do have a 14-day free trial, and they do plan to release in July 2020. Okay, so let's overview some of the features. I'm actually going to use the 37-minute product tour that their founder actually goes through on YouTube. So I'll include that link below if you want to watch the full feature with him overviewing some of the features. So what's interesting is the features really revolve around you not being overwhelmed by email. So the first feature that they have is something called an inbox. I genuinely thought it was a typo, and I thought, how did you get that typo wrong? But it actually stands for important inbox or important emails. And what it's essentially trying to do is change the way that we think about emails. Instead of having this constant sort of thread of emails coming through that are just from, say, loads of different sources, it tries to channel only the most important emails. And as you're using it, apparently it learns over time about what are those important emails. And what it does with the other emails is it puts it into something called the feed, which I quite like because it almost social networks, newsletters, and things that you commonly will be browsing. This could be, you know, everything from newsletters to company updates and things like that that are less important and not sent by a human per se. So that's quite cool. There's inbox and the feed. They have this sort of tertiary area. Well, they have loads of areas, but one is called paper trail. And I really like this concept. So what it does is it strips anything that is from the feed and inbox, but doesn't put them there. That is, like, say, receipts or sort of like documents of invoices, and puts them in this thing called a paper trail so that you can find them on reference at any given time. It's sort of like having an Evernote built inside of your email, and sort of works in a way that segregates that all into one area. Now, there's actually tons of like these smaller features, and maybe I won't caption them all in today's video, but I want to feature a couple of them here. So obviously when you're emailing, you may have an email that comes in that you don't necessarily want to reply straight away to. They have this feature called Reply Later, which doesn't necessarily snooze it. It actually puts it into a new window called Focus and Reply Later. So you've got this dedicated window that you can actually go and focus in on, and actually draws the emails to your attention. I think in Gmail, if you had to do that, you'd have to create some form of label and then just like manage a system or a workflow for it, whereas this actually designs it up front. So it sort of like beats snooze in a way, which is quite interesting. So for example, there are like two things that allow you to clip pieces of information inside of an email. You can say if there's an email that you've got that you want to save for later that could be useful for reference, could be useful for travel, could be useful just for general access. So there's a feature called Set Aside, which actually takes it away and puts it in a separate, almost like starring your emails to some extent, but useful for those sort of on-the-go situations, almost you know, pinning them into this dedicated area. But there's also this feature called Clip, and you have an area called My Clips. And basically what you can do from here is essentially take any clipping that could be specific, like a phone number or like an article or things like that, and actually clip it into My Clips area. They've got some quite cool features for teams, I guess, or people that work in constant sort of threads. And they've got this thing called like merge threads, where if you've got an email that's sort of similar to another email that you've started that's on the same topic, you can merge threads so that the emails come together as one, which is quite interesting. There's another feature called change subject as well. So if somebody sends you an email that, you know, is very complicated subject line, or you want to change it yourself, what's quite cool is you can actually modify it your end, which makes it better for search, makes it better for, you know, being able to access those files pretty instantaneously. So apparently whenever you've got a conversation open, you can actually add personal and private notes that won't be seen by the people in the thread to this. This is actually a handy feature I actually use in Missive occasionally to leave myself notes to reference for later. So one of the major features I actually missed, and I guess something that could be important, is the screening ability. So there's the feature called screening, essentially like screening phone calls. You can basically approve people to come inside of your inbox or inbox, and that actually saves you a bit of time in terms of like whether you want to be spammed by certain people or actually have messages come in. And you can actually reject them and they'll just disappear into the system. So it's really trying to protect your attention span and really trying to defend against unwanted messages. Now, some of the finer details, Hey actually blocks spy tracking. So it actually blocks out those sort of pixel tracking that is sent by applications like Newton, Missive, like read receipts, so that they can actually detect when a person emails that, so you won't be able to get sort of like hidden stuff inside the email that you don't know about coming your way. So looking at the manifesto, there's some quite interesting stuff. They really try and centralize this around a belief system, which I think is good. Like if you're thinking of changing a system, then if you've got like this sort of mantra to go by, you'll continually refine the features to fit that need. And apparently, you know, the first thing is it's a platform, not a client. So they're actually building this from the bottom up, full email service provider. They want to attain, not your attention, like sort of like distracting you away from thing, and try and make you get less email, focus on workflows, not workarounds, start fresh as well. A lot of people overwhelmed by their current emails in Gmail. You can download your data as well anytime, so you can import it back into Gmail if in say 2 years this fails. But I can imagine with Basecamp they've meticulously selected how this is going to work. So this is actually a really useful piece of content to overview, and it's definitely worth a read about how they believe about you don't need to read anything, you need to surface, you don't need to dig for information. and really keep you in this flow state. So the article will be below, and it's quite interesting. So I've covered the features, obviously there are some more, I've covered the pricing and also some of the manifesto pieces. So in my opinion, I think hey.com will be quite an interesting release. I think email probably needed something like this, an additional player, and I will be checking it out and giving you my full opinion after I've tried it for say a week. Get some of those emails in there and give you my thoughts on it. So folks, a big thank you for stopping by today. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please do like it if you found value. Let me know your thoughts on hey.com and naturally subscribe if you are brand new. But folks, I'll see you in a future Keep Productive video and thank you very much for stopping by today. Cheers everyone. Bye.